today we've been reading. Oh, and just like I'll take that one. Yeah. Right. So did anyone else have any questions that they want to ask each other?
Yeah, I mean, the last couple of weeks have probably been where we've been talking a lot about race and diversity. So what does it all mean to you guys?
It's been too hard living.
I'll let someone else go first.
Who's gonna go first?
What does race and diversity mean to you?
I don't know.
What's the first thing that comes to your mind? Racism is what you think about when you hear the words race and diversity. Okay.
Yeah.
How about you guys?
What about you, Shay? What does it mean to you? What does it mean to you when you think about race and diversity?
What is race?
Yeah, is that's a good question.
I think
would you like to learn more about it in school, do you think?
Yeah.
I think that's a good thing, isn't it, to learn about how we're all really different in some ways, but actually we're really all the same. And I think the importance of that would be great to learn in a school environment, so you can all learn each other's cultures, but at the end of the day you're still all friends, aren't you, and you still all play together, and you're all just people, which I think is a nice message.
And I think particularly with Rami's, can I talk about vitiligo? Mm-hmm. Particularly with Rami's vitiligo, the fact that his skin can change colour really highlights how we are all the same underneath, aren't we? The pigment in our skin is not always permanent, is it? And it is just pigment, it's just cells, and we do have different cultures, but underneath we're all the same.
Yeah.
So we've actually, Lulu, written a few things about how to move forward or what would be great to do. Do you want to read it out, Lulu? But speak up. Don't you do it, Luli? These are your words. Right, so she's written, we need to learn from each other about each other. We need to be curious about different heritage in a positive way. And we need to stand up for inequality.
Really good.
Well done.
Well done, Lulu.
Well done.
Clap, big clap. I like that. That's really good.
How about you, Harrison and Tony?
I think we, especially since Audrey's been born, we've learned a lot about kind of different cultures and race, but mainly about how people can react differently to you, because, I mean, Audrey's living in a wholly white household, and a lot of our family we visit are just mainly comprised of white people. So I think people kind of say things that are inappropriate without even realising. So, for instance, every single time I visit my sister's house, my nephew goes, I just love her hair, and he has to scruff up her hair every single time. I love it. He's trying to be really nice, but it's just so frustrating that it has to be pointed out every time, and that he has to mess it up, because to do Audrey's hair takes ages. You just like, don't touch it. And that can be it, but it's interesting that he doesn't really know that would be something that would, it might hurt somebody or make you think, why does this have to be mentioned all the time? Because you've never mentioned my hair or Harrison's hair. And I think kind of an awakening, like, to people that need to see that. I guess, I don't know how you do that without living with it, you know, and kind of going, this is something that you need to look at. Even I see comments on kind of Facebook that can make me feel uncomfortable, and I don't want to comment back because I don't want to kind of get in an argument. But sometimes I feel like, well, if I don't say anything, I kind of like I'm letting that pass, like that's okay for you to kind of comment about things like that. And so that for me is something that, you know, and we get upset sometimes, and it's really strange to be part of that, I guess, which that's something that we didn't know really before. And I thought, you know, I was quite welcoming to people from different cultures, and because I've always found it more interesting than anything else. But I didn't realise that I would feel that way. You know, the biggest thing actually, Claire saw a picture, didn't you, the other day? And there's a one story that I've told since Audrey was really kind of quite small. And we went to Smith's on Edge Lane and looked at a doll, and I said, Claire, you will not believe what happened. It was the craziest thing. Literally, there's a row of these, I think they're called Our Generation dolls, and they go from floor to ceiling and across the whole aisle. And I went, oh, let's have a look here, Audrey. And I was like, not a single one. It was difficult to find one with dark hair that looked like me, never mind one that looked like Audrey. And I was like, I had a shock. And there's a picture circulating now of a young girl with white skin looking at a million dolls that have kind of darker skin. And I said, this is what happened to me. And I try and show people and they go, well, what do you mean? It's not in that shop. I said, that's not a real shop. Like that's how you feel, you know. And that's been my biggest thing to tell people. This is how it feels to kind of understand what's going on at the minute, what things need to change. But I'm not sure how you progress, you know, to make people understand that feeling without feeling it himself, because I certainly didn't until I was there. I guess more sharing stories.
Yeah, I think people are listening more, aren't they? And these videos and conversations are really helpful to people. Things like that, sharing those stories, are really helpful. So for us, World Book Day is a nightmare because there are no, or when we started, there were no characters that Rami could dress up as, none. Roald Dahl Day, no one. You know, he's been a fox, but there were no other characters.
Yeah, animals.
Yeah, there are more animal books than people of colour. So that's really interesting.
I think it's lucky in that school, though. It's really diverse, our school.
Yeah. But do you think it would be also great if it's not only the students that would be diverse, it would actually higher the diversity, or actually children to see teachers that look like them as well?
Yeah,
so for example, I thought, was it 2 years ago when Miss Eunice was there? I thought that was brilliant for someone to actually see someone who looks different and also be a teacher.
Yeah. Yeah, it's nice. I always think it adds to people when you have a lot of people, different types of people. Oh, careful, Audrey.
It's like feeling in a position of like a leadership, that if you can see yourself in that position, then so you'll be more inclined to do that. So to get into a profession such as teaching or being, I don't know, an astronaut or an engineer, if you can see someone that looks like you doing that job, you feel more comfortable that you can then achieve that yourself. Representation matters, really.
It's been a long time coming, but I know change.